there are so many things that you can do in Rec Room that not a lot of people know about. So in this video, I'm going to be showing you features that more people should know. First, a feature you didn't know was in Rec Room is that you can support me by going to my profile and pressing the big support button. Okay, but for real, let's start with a feature that I know will be very useful for builders that don't have Rec Room Studio and want official looking furniture in their rooms, or for people that are just lazy like me. In the ink space area, also known as the second 3D charades area, there's a ton of furniture like beanbags, couches, and even this working retro stereo. And if you either copy the 3D charades room or make a room with the ink space template, you can actually move these pieces of furniture around, size them up, freeze them, recolor them, and even duplicate them if you need to. You can also just straight up delete the exterior of the ink space, and all of the furniture that's usable will remain in the room, which helps a lot with ink. And while I'm not 100% sure whether this is actually intentional or just a bug that they never noticed, I do think that this is a very useful feature. And you may remember when I said that you can recolor these pieces of furniture. Well, you can actually recolor a lot of the props and furniture from the maker pen. You can even recolor stuff like the fire on the campfire for some reason. Unfortunately, you can't recolor everything, like you can't recolor these sitting logs, for example, which kind of sucks. However, I honestly really like using the maker pen props, and I think this is very useful to use in rooms like the dorm room. And while on the topic of the maker pen props, there's a certain prop that allows you to get certain photos and artwork on your walls without having to use, for example, Rec Room Studio or a printing station. And that item is the showcase poster. By putting this on your wall and pressing the configure option, you can customize it so that only the photo of what you want to showcase appears on the poster. The only downside of this is that the photo has to be an event photo or room photo, but it's not that big of a downside in my opinion, and it's worth it if you want to customize your dorm room with a bunch of photos easily. Speaking of the dorm room, there's a very easy way to make it so that you can run in your dorm room, since you're usually very slow in there. In order to enable running, you need to go to your watch, go to this room at the bottom, then go to this settings, and at the top of the menu, scroll right until you see game roles and click on that. Then click on the cogwheel next to the dorm room, grab the maker pen that appears in front of you if you don't already have it out, then go to locomotion and look for the can sprint option. If it's not checked already, press the override button so that it is checked, and finally make the option go to yes. Now you can sprint in your dorm room, and as you can tell, you are so much faster now than you were before. And this setting is very useful for the next thing I want to talk about, getting a bigger dorm room. If you haven't already noticed, the dorm room is pretty restricted, and when you go too far out of it, you get teleported back. But above the dorm room, there is a small area that doesn't teleport you back, and you're able to build a small room here if you wanted to. Okay, next let's talk about cosmetic features. Have you ever worn some sort of helmet and you really like how it looks and want to use it in one of your outfits, but it changes the hair to this weird hair that's normally not in the hair select screen and you don't like it at all? Well, if you press the adjust button that appears when you equip the hat and press this cogwheel with an arrow button, you can toggle whether the helmet hair appears or not. This is super useful and a very good feature that they added so that you can decide whether you want helmet hair or not, or even so that you can be more creative with different hat and hair combos. You can also mess around with where certain items go on your head, so if you didn't already know that, there you go. Okay, next let's discuss a few features in Make It to Midnight. I think a lot of people already know this one, but I'm still going to include it for the people that don't. You can easily go outside the main starting area without starting the game. When you spawn in, to the right where the boards containing information about the different perks you're going to lock is, there's a simple path that leads you to one of the exits that you can escape from in the game, and since the exit is open, it doesn't have an invisible barrier, you could just walk right through and explore the map. This is extremely useful if you want to take pictures of stuff, or just to scope out areas you can hide without being chased by a clown while doing so. And speaking of Bunky the Clown, have you ever needed green screen photos of him? Well, if you have access to the streamer cam and go to the stream mixer, you're actually able to turn on a green screen as well as adjust the lighting. Now, this doesn't show up on your camera, unfortunately, but if you're on PC, which I'm assuming you are because you have streamer cam, then you can just use a snipping tool or something to take photos, so. And speaking of taking photos, have you ever tried to take a photo on the screen mode version of Rec Room only for you to look completely stupid, like you're not posing at all? Well, fear not. There's a simple way to make it look like you're posing on VR when in reality, you're not even on VR, and in order to do this, you first have to go to settings and enable the option to go into third person. Then you have to press this button next to your character's portrait to go into third person. For me, it's V. Then you're going to want to hold down that same button, which will bring up this dance menu, and choose whatever dance you like. I chose this bottom dance because it looks nice. And finally, hold this button on the bottom right of your screen. For me, it's G, and position your character however you want. Now your character looks like they're posing on VR when in fact, they're actually on screen mode.